weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Yeah, me too.
Okay, this is turning into a Scooby-Doo episode, isn't it? So I have to find some boards to fix my own window.
Hey, Henry?
Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
It's the right mess here. Who the hell's... Raleigh,
you know Raleigh Fingers? He pitched for the A's?
No.
Well, I'm the spitting image of him.
Oh, wait, is he the guy with the snidely whiplash thing going on from the 70s? Ooh, my dad loved him.
Yeah, that's him.
That mustache. Now you have my attention.
Okay.
Yeah, that was...
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see... In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
It's hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
Clothes. That.
Clothes? I don't really think about it.
Yes.
Come on.
I got a sweatshirt I like, good jacket I got at the Buckle Barn.
Ooh, I love the Buckle Barn.
Just one of those brown ones, you know?
I do. Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
Eyes? Thick beard. Apparently I think I had a beard. Didn't have it in my little... My nose has been broken. I think I've got a beard.
I know it's not easy.
Pretty thick. Beard.
Oh.
I'd have to look
at... Have you always had a beard?
Okay.
For a while, yeah.
All right.
I picked up a book.
Perfect.
And saw myself...
about your eyes.
Frolicking.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
You're what?
Is that okay? Don't answer. I'm gonna do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes, tell me.
Him? Steely. Tired right about now.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
That is very true.
Speak for yourself, mister.
But I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished. Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
What's a spigot? And where is it? Is that a spigot? That might be a spigot. What's this? Those are not boards. Right, I'm trying to find more boards. But I'd like to investigate. That's a cistern. Spigot! Apparently is a way to get your feet wet. Excellent. I guess I shouldn't be stealing the boards from the signs. Okay. Now that she's not annoying me with questions about what I look like, let's focus. Is two enough? No? Ah, there's another one. Three's got to be enough. It's not that big a window. There you go. There were already two boards hammered up there. Why didn't I take all the boards up with me the first time? I mean, I seem pretty athletic, actually, jumping up and down and climbing and you know what. Falling, partly. So, I've got to find who did this, I assume. Right now, the obvious suspects are the annoying teenage girls. However, there's that man, that strange-looking man who had a flashlight, just
like me. I got that window all patched up. So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task, and I'll give it to you.
So, why is there a toolbox? I was fixing a window. Flora of the Shushon poster. A calendar. Fine, I'm ready to work.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
I am glad to hear you've really thought this through.
Yeah.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
You know, it's not really that comfy. I mean, it's wooden and there's no padding.
I actually got
a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aw. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
Oh, God. I may have lost a few days.
Hello, Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Maybe?
Not too bad. I could get used to it out here.
That's nice. Look, I called with bad news. Two young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing.
Oh,
they've
God.
Got parents out in California.
Chelsea!
Haven't heard from them in a week. They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
Oh, brilliant. No, it's them.
You should tell whoever that I'm happy to be questioned.
Look, it's not going to be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
No. It's just...
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to
the cops. Don't keep it vague. Tell them everything. I went there.
All right, Henry, thanks.
Even tell them about the radio. It's always best. Seriously, tell them about the radio. You threw the radio and you were grumpy. You stole a bottle of their whiskey. You confiscated it. And then...
Henry, wake up.
Okay.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
I'm out of bed.
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Whoa! But it's late. No. You're the big dumb idiot.
Hi, Jules.
Oh, you sound tired.
I decided against the idiot comment at the last second.
Are you having a nice time?
It's good here. I'm fine. Yeah, what about you?
Sure. Are you? Everything good there? Jules?
What? Oh, sorry, Henry. Yeah, I'm good.
Well, that's good.
Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
Okay, Jules.
How
Delilah seems nice.
Mm-hmm, sure.
Bye, baby.
Was that it? That was me... Not much for social skills, am I? Okay, what's... Two folks, okay. Hike north and retrieve...
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well, I get my stuff hand-delivered.
Oh, how's that work?
It's the perks of a decade of service. You're out hiking in 90-degree heat, and I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair? Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more.
Okay.
There should be loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky. You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it.
I bet she's precise.
She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Can you not grow marijuana out here? I don't know. I don't know what the growing conditions for marijuana need to be.
So, like, 2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night?
Did I?
You were sleeping, I guess, and... All I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles. I just thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation, and I'd just be spoiling it.
Wait.
I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
Are you saying that didn't... Are you saying that didn't happen? I dreamt that conversation?
I shouldn't be out here.
Yes, you should.
No, I just ran away from my problems.
No, you didn't. We all fuck up. Look. So, a couple of months before I took this job, I was with this guy, Javier. Ugh, he's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper.
That's nice.
We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Waltz was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home. Javier said it was fine, he'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor. I've just lied about it for over 10 years, and, for some reason, I wanted you to know.
Okay, I guess...
I figured you've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Okay, there's a fork in the path. Right here. So we're kind of getting to know each other quite a lot, I guess. She's not a psycho killer. Oh, she is, isn't she? She killed those girls. Is it bad? There's a little side of me thinking. They kind of had it coming. No, that is terrible. Of course they didn't. Of course they did not.
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
But, you know, I like her. I don't like those teenagers. That's terrible. Don't think like that. You've been out here for too long. Okay, where am I again? I'm two forks, aren't I? Let's just double check that. I don't want to get this wrong. Two forks lookout we got. Yeah, two forks. Do we have other lookouts on here? Yeah, two forks. So just take the two forks stuff. Not spruce or moss peak. Okay, got it. Think. Don't do it. Don't do it. Okay, report. Heading home. Okay, I got it. I'm done.
All right. I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Yeah.
Who do you think I am?
Yeah. I could steal everyone else's food. Oh.
You've got a front row seat for what okay. might be the biggest fire of the year.
Yeah. Really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer.
Really? Do they last that long?
She doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
I'm not calling it. How about the flapjack? What about Delilah?
So no ideas, huh?
How about the flapjack fire?
Maybe we call it the flapjack fire. Can you sell that as a name?
You really like that, huh?
Yeah, I said I did. It's funny.
Fair enough.
I don't want to call it the Delilah in case she took offense.
He'll probably ask me if it was a camp cooking accident or something.
Because, you know, she's about my only friend. She might have thought it was hilarious. I suspect...
So there's this creek down the hill. And, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on
Not
nights
whiskey.
Like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
Okay... I would if I was with you. I'm not flirting with her, I'm married.
I'm sure I would. Sounds pretty great.
It is. Are you looking at the fire?
I am.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke.
Checking around, because I'm...
When the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
Kay?
I'm glad you're here.
Yeah, what?
Why do you say that?
Because I do. I'm not crazy. I mean, we've had such a good time, right?
Little, yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. And I know you're not really available, but... I want you to know, well... Maybe it'd be nice to get together at the end of the summer.
Dangerous territory! Really dangerous territory!
Look, we don't have to plan or even talk about it. I'm just having the thought. I wish I was over there. It'd be nice to be near somebody.
No, I get it, but...
We could talk without these radios. We could, you know...
Yes, I know, but,
It'd be nice to be close to someone.
This is just like...
Why don't we both just go watch this fire and try to imagine all the old dead things it's burning away?
Sure.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher.
What?
That reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Oh, reply, problem bear, sure thing.
Sure, no problem. Remember me fondly.
You are such a drama queen.
Ugh, can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
Okay. Search the lakeside for bear tracks. And that's the supply drop. Where am I searching it? Which lake? Was it this lake? 5 Mile Creek? No, that was where I picked up. Well, it is the only body of water that's called a lake, so that really does have to be it. That's a basin. Just when they said bears, I, for some reason, thought it would be up there. But, Jonesy Lake, we're going west. In the direction I was facing. Probably was a hint, wasn't it? You're facing in this direction. That's the way you're going. How do I take the fishing rod out again? Can I? I guess that will happen automatically. Okay, at least the teenagers... Well, we know the teenagers are not back, I guess. Nobody else is back making a mess. I always get unnerved by the sounds of the bushes rustling. Okay. That was a... Was that a duck whistle or something? Someone duck hunting? Am I going to get shot? Okay.
Someone left their clipboard out here.
It could have been one of the Fish and Game folks. See if there's a name or a credential or something. I can call it in.
I don't know why, but I want to just... Okay. Examine. It's not... Oh, what? That's better.
It's... Holy shit.
What's going on? You didn't actually find a bear, did you?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Locate...
Henry? I'm worried.
Locate strange noise towards
you
the canyon.
You didn't find and eat any mushrooms, did you? I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know,
I am not high.
Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo? Oh, God. I don't know why I just called you that.
I found a walkie-talkie out here, too.
Okay.
Somebody's been listening to
it's
our conversation.
Shithouse.
Well, get it if you haven't already, and then we'll figure out whose it is.
Will do.
Oh, God! What?
Henry? Are you there? What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head, punched or something by someone.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
How am I talking without my radio?
I don't know.
Well, there
Jesus
it is.
Christ.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with, what, transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
But they didn't, did they?
What the fuck is going on?
What's Wapiti Station?
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now.
Okay.
It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
I'll start hiking that way now.
North shore.
Damn it, my head.
Of the lake.
Are you sure you saw what you saw, Henry? Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Why would I make this up? It's an insane lie at worst and a shitty prank at best.
And you've been feeling okay?
I'm not eating mushrooms.
Okay, I'm sorry. I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
No, they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
Our entire relationship, friendship, our whole summer.
I just want to check.
Someone is out here with a walkie-talkie taking notes and talking to God knows who. What do you think is going on behind that fence?
Apparently a lot of following you around taking notes, which is unfucking believable, Henry.
Yeah, you're telling me. All right, I'm on my way to Wapiti Meadow. I'll let you know what I find.
Okay.
Can we call it?
There's got to be a reasonable explanation. Also, I'm going to call around and see if anyone's had anything weird happen to them or seemed spooked. I don't want to make this bigger than it is yet, you know?
Yeah, understood.
Can we rename this place? Because...
Hike safe.
I feel a little daft. I know my life is in danger, but every time you say Wapiti Meadow, I get the urge to giggle. There is a note. Okay, let's...
Who are these guys, Ron and Dave? They're leaving notes for each other in the boxes. Is there any chance that they had anything to do with those girls disappearing?
No, they're both rangers. They're not out here this season. I didn't really know them that well, but I always assumed the only thing Ron cared about was chasing tail and getting loaded. It's somehow comforting to know that he was able to keep up a correspondence with someone who wasn't going to send him a topless Polaroid.
Okay. Ron, got some bad news back home, so hopefully they'll let me out of here for a while. Who's to say? Though budgets being what they are. Did you get my note about what went down in Wapiti? Sheriff isn't too pleased with me, but I don't know. I probably overdid it. Wish you would have been there. I guess you must have got hung up. Dave, P.S. Amigos is Spanish and Profesionales is Italian. Okay, that's... strange. Supply... old sweater and okay, yeah, weird. I'll close the supply. Right, so I've got to carry on to Wapiti following the path. Was it north from here? No, that's down into the canyon. Or is that the way I no, that's a different canyon. There's no river. That is a different. Yes, it is. Okay. Hopefully I've got enough rope to last me now. I'm expecting someone to smack me in the head or sever the rope. That's a little freaky. Yes, it is. Am I going north? Yes, I am. So, follow the path. I guess I'm not actually going fishing. Am I? Still want to go north. I'm just a little curious. Damaged tree. Chopped down. I don't have an axe. So I'm not chopping the damaged tree down. Am I supposed to do that? Okay, I found the fence.
Okay, I'm at the fence. I don't see anyone around, but I'm not sure I can get past it.
How big is it?
Big. It goes off in both directions. Acres.
What the fuck is going on out here?
Whatever it is, someone doesn't want anyone to know about it.
Sometimes biologists will cordon off a little area to study flora or whatever, but that's only a few square feet usually.
That's not what this is.
We'll see what you can do to get past it.
Okay, before I do that...
Looks like goddamn Area 51.
Maybe they've got aliens. That'd be exciting.
Yeah, we'll see about that.
Yeah.
And what are the odds they left the gate unlocked?
Pretty low, I'd imagine.
Shh! That was worth a try, was it? Okay.
Look, I'm not gonna be able to get into this place.
Shit.
I don't know how long I can dick around out here until someone notices.
God, if you were an actual firefighter, you'd have that gate down in two shakes.
Why?
Hey, actually, those guys doing the controlled burn, they might be able to help.
Where are they?
Beyond Ruby River, there's a scout camp. They burned a line a few days ago that should let you hike right to them.
Well, that's great.
Look for patrol burns south of the Ruby River.
The guys who would help you get through that fence.
So now I have to go... Right. No, that's where I am. South of the Ruby River. Where the hell is the Ruby... There's the Ruby River! South Scout Camp. Okay, that's miles away. Fine.
Hey, I called around. Things seem normal with everyone else.
Okay.
Has anything strange been happening on your end?
No. Nothing really.
Nothing really or nothing?
Nothing. My door was open the other night, but that's not strange.
That doesn't sound like nothing.
It's nothing, I promise.
Yeah.
Right. I'm headed toward the camp anyway.
That sounds like something to me.
Keep your radio close to you.
I will.
Hey, what you just said, keep my radio close to me.
Yeah?
Before I got attacked back at the lake, I saw a radio on the ground, kind of like the one I use.
And?
Do you think that maybe someone was, you know,
I don't know. What?
Maybe intercepting our frequency with other radios or something.
Henry...
Well, they know our conversation.
I don't even know how you would do that.
Yeah, well, you sound worried.
No. I'm not, okay? Let's not spin out of control. Just keep hiking.
I'm hiking.
Whatever you say, boss.
Supply cache is done. Okay. I have no idea why I want to do that. Was it as creepy as this last time? With all the, you know... mist around your ankles. Very horror movie, shall we say.
I know we don't know what's going on yet, but I don't have have a good feeling.
No.
I don't like feeling vulnerable. It's not like you can just call the police.
Why not?
I was thinking about the good ones. It just struck me that if anything weird like this happened to them, happened to Brian, just how scared he would have been.
Okay.
I'm sure he's fine, Delilah. I mean, don't you think if this started happening to them, he or his dad would have said something?
I don't know. Ned was a weird guy.
No, nobody is that weird. The moment you hear someone in the bushes or get punched from the shadows, you're getting your boss on the phone.
Yeah.
True that.
Brian is fine.
I hope so.
Or dead.
It was 3 years ago. He's in high school now. He's on summer break.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Dead's another thing that would stop you getting in touch with your boss. Looks kind of creepy now, for some odd reason. Come on, thank you. I'm going to get to the top one of these and someone's going to kick me in the face. I can feel it. Either that or I'm paranoid. One or the other. We'll see which before long, I assume. Maybe we should take a vote. Could straw poll it. Am I paranoid? Or not. Okay. Well, my lookout towers.
Whoa, the flapjack fire isn't going anywhere, huh?
No, that's why those guys came out to burn that line. It's at the stage where all we can do is pay attention to it.
They're not gonna try to put it out?
Not yet, apparently.
Okay, I don't quite understand that. They gotta let it burn itself out, I guess? Something like that. Not an expert on putting out forest fires, strangely enough. So where the hell am I? Right, I want to keep going south and slightly west, and then when I cross the river, turn east. South and slightly west. This direction. Thought it was a cat. Thought it was a castle for a while. Keep going here. Okay, we've got relaxing music tab. I think I see a supply box. Yes, yes, I still have the urge to loot. Don't you judge me. It's stuff. Besides, I'm out here trying to survive, and survival is about stuff. Yes, it is. It's all about the stuff. You either have stuff, or you die. Okay, map updated. There is a note I also have. Terminal 7. Toilet paper! Old toilet paper. More toilet paper. Cones, books. Jane Eyre. And a note. Let's just do the note. Okay. Ron, really wish the powers that be could issue us radios that didn't suck ass. Most of the time, I prefer to keep things to pen and paper. But every once in a while, it'd be nice to get a hold of you right away. My sister keeps leaving me messages at the main office, but I don't think she gets that I took the job so I wouldn't have to deal with her or Mum. I've been sitting at the spot for a while now, thinking about what to say to her, but I'm a quarter way through this bottle of Fife's instead. Miss you, Dave. Oh. So Ron and Dave were together, at least? That's how it kind of sees. Do I report this in? Apparently not. Okay. Were their radios not working then?
I found where they did the controlled burn. I can hike right through here now.
Yeah, normally they wouldn't do that so close to a body of water, but I think they're extra worried about a fire jumping the river and burning up to Two Forks now that there's someone in it.
Well, I'm extra appreciative of that.
I am.
Let's see. The scout camp is southeast of the river.
Yeah.
There should be a pond on the way.
I think I see it.
What happens if a controlled burn gets out of control?
Someone gets fired.
Ugh, are you serious?
Oh, come on. That one was an honest accident. I'm not even in the mood for wordplay. That's how wound up all this shit has me.
Okay. We have what looked like... snowmobile?
There's some old snowmobiles out here.
That's crazy.
Looks like one of the poor bastards was cruising across this pond and dumped it.
Do snowmobiles work on ponds?
That was not a fun hike back to civilization.
Or does it get that cold in winter here? Because... I mean... alright, fair enough. Am I still heading in the right direction? Yes, indeed. Keep heading towards the scout camp. So they're going to help me get through the fence. How? Do they have bolt cutters? An axe would be nice. I've got a tree to chop down. I don't know why I want to chop a tree down. Camp Arapaho. Arapaho. Okay.
The bridge to the camp is out.
Damn.
I'm gonna walk the ravine and see if I can find some high ground to get across.
Good plan.
Which way, though? When I say I'm gonna walk the ravine, do I mean walk to the north? Probably not. Yeah, no, that's the north. That's the south. No. Can I jump this? Doesn't look like it, does it? Walk the ravine to... No? Really? How about there, then? Oh, no, it is here. It is here. It's a long drop. Okay, I just didn't get close enough. I didn't get close enough to it. All right. Oh, God, that is a long drop. Okay. And which way do I want to be going from here? Slightly south for a little while and then around. Follow the trail. This does not look inhabited.
I'm at the camp.
Great. Have a look around. If anyone's still there, they might be able to help.
I'm gonna sound crazy.
Maybe you just ask them to help you get inside the fence. If I didn't know it was out there, they probably don't either.
This place looks dead, but I'll see what I can find. I guess these little shelters are where they keep the Weeblos.
For the past 35 years, yeah.
The what?
You ever talked to any of the scouts?
No, they haven't been out here in a while, and I generally don't have a lot to say to preteens.
Unless it's Brian Goodwin.
Well, if forced, I mean, I can make conversation with anyone. Plus, it was sort of fun to hear about all of his nerdy hobbies.
Okay.
I mean, he wasn't a scout or a Weeblo or whatever?
Since that boy could barely tie his shoes, let alone a clove hitch.
What the hell's a clove hitch?
Well, it's a knot that you are probably too old and too stubborn to learn. You use it to make rafts and shelters and stuff like that.
Huh. You know how to tie one?
Heck no. I'd make a Weeblo do it.
Okay.
Yeah, these guys are gone. I found where they were sitting around before getting picked up.
Damn.
Okay.
I found an axe.
If one of the crew left it, that thing is actually called a Pulaski.
It looks like an axe to me. This thing will be a huge help.
Yes!
Getting through the backcountry and getting through that fence.
Right! And chopping trees down, apparently. Okay.
Hey, Dee, they left something behind. It's like a memo from their boss.
that say anything of note?
Next few days, dropping into the thoroughfare on behalf of Dr. Simmons at Wapiti Station.
Wapiti Station?
Holy crap.
Keep reading.
Oh, I just thought I would maybe, you know, stop there, let the mystery percolate.
My mother always said I would need someone to give me a taste of my own medicine.
They're running a research site out there. He was worried about wildfires.
Someone is writing down our conversations. And now we find out there's a research site out here that we don't know about? What are they researching? I mean, you and I aren't very interesting.
Us. They're researching us.
Are they?
You think they're studying you and me?
I do, yeah. I mean, maybe it's about studying two strangers who talk every day.
Like, if you put someone in isolation with someone else...
Oh, no, it's just a guess.
Yeah, that's what I think.
Well, fuck that.
Exactly.
Agreed.
I think we should allow for the possibility that this is all just a big misunderstanding, but... God, if you saw what you said you did... Fuck, Henry.
Yeah, I saw it.
Okay. So what's next?
Well, I've got an axe, so I can figure out a way to get over the ravine and back towards the site.
Oh.
Sounds good. Check in when you can, and keep an eye out for anyone following you.
Yeah, yeah. When he said I have an axe, I was thinking, and I'm going to use it. But,
I found a little trowel. Maybe I should take it with me. Could use it to pop open beers.
Wow. 99% sure that's for burying poop.
And I'm holding it.
No.
Maybe drop it?
Yeah. Thanks for those pearls of wisdom. So I have to get all the way back up to Wapiti Meadow. Oh, good grief. That is one hell of a hike. I should stomp out the campfire. Where is the camp? Okay, that's a bit odd. I'm stamping it out there, not there. But fine. Okay, I've stamped the campfire out. We don't want to leave it burning. Where are the scouts? We've not really... Whoa, okay. Yeah. Oh. How the hell do I get across here, then? I mean, I'm not going to be able to do the long jump, am I? So let's have a look. What am I missing? North does not look like an... Oh, no, north. North does look like an option, actually, doesn't it? Yes, it does. Continue through the camp and find another way out of this area. I've already stomped the campfire out because we didn't travel... I thought for a second I heard someone. I really did. I could have sworn I heard someone. There's a gap there that's blocked trail. And... No, okay, so this is blocked. Well then, how in the actual do I get out of here? Okay, I think the symbol... is a broken tree. Oh! Trees that I can chop down. There are symbols of trees I can chop down. If I can chop a tree down, because I now have an axe, I can get across the gorge, yeah? So what I need to do... Block... I can't. Oh, I can clear it! I can clear it! With an axe! Yeah. Should have thought of that, shouldn't I? Yes, I should! But that's not a tree to chop down, and I'm pretty sure it said there was a tree to chop down. Right ahead. There we go. And I'm to chop them down so that I have a path. Got it. Oh, there's another tree over there. I can't cross that. Oh, look at that. Hop over? You mean, hop over the... Ah, right, there you go. So, brilliant. We've got a cross. We've now got an axe.
Are you there? I had a thought.
Okay.
Let's hear it.
You heard someone in the bushes.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's assume we're being tailed. Or you are, at least. Where are you right now?
Just on my way back, in and out of trees, in the middle of nowhere.
Do you see anybody?
No, definitely not.
All right, so tell me what you think of this.
What the hell was that?
Did you just cough?
No. Did you just cough?
No.
Oh, fuck.
Somebody's listening to us.
There isn't any way someone, like another lookout, could be on this line, is there?
No. Not without tapping our radios. Get in your tower, shut the door. Don't leave, and don't use your radio. I'll call you. Understand? I will call you.
Okay.
Thoroughfare Tower, this is Two Forks calling you for the, 50th time today.
She did say she would call us.
The flapjack fire continues to move in a southerly fashion. Delilah, for fuck's sake, answer your radio.
Hello, sunshine. Sorry, went out for a little bit. What can I do you for?
You can do me for a trip out of here. Oh yeah, why are you...
I didn't sleep a wink last night, and I've been going crazy for the past 6 hours of sunup. How are you so chipper?
Well, it's a new day. What a day, this day we've been given.
Maybe I am actually asleep right now. Maybe I didn't stay up all night knowing that someone is...
I actually slept just great.
Okay.
She's
crazy. By the way, I was wondering if your Flora of the Shoshone info poster was still up inside your tower?
What?
It's just protocol that those stay up. You know, info about your tower, the surrounding tree species, etc.
It's a code! It's a code!
Just, you know, have a look at it.
It's a code! She knows somebody is listening to us. God, I'm slow.